Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment. You can listen to The Mike O'Mara Show at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
Let's get started.
It's The Mike O'Mara Show with Mike O'Mara, Oscar Santana, and Rob Spiewak. Now, here's Mike.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to The Mike O'Mara Show. We are heard all over the place. Jacksonville, Illinois. Lake Charles, Louisiana. Denmark, Iowa. Mexico, Missouri. Never heard of that one. Cool that somebody's listening to us there.
I love it.
Thunder Bay, Ontario, Canada. Heard of that. Good,
yes.
Junior hockey up there. And my beloved of all the towns, Muncie, Indiana.
Mike, you know, I take such great pleasure in gathering the towns every week.
Yes.
But that one was special to type
that
out.
In your depleted condition.
Yes.
And Rob's here with us, and we'll be here. You going to stay through the news today?
Absolutely, if you'll have me.
Wonderful. Love to have you. And Rob Spiewak with his modified schedule, which we're going to get paid back on big time.
Oh, I think, you know, as I said in a thread with Pony and Rob, as long as Rob's alive.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah, that's all that matters right now.
Exactly. Yeah. And Rob dropped a bomb on us right before airtime that said he's got,
breaking news.
And by the way, when you do that, I hope it's something really good.
Really good.
Okay. All right. Well, what do you have for us? What do you have?
Okay. Well, at 8:45, normally the time that I hook up with Pony to do the show, my phone rings and it's my doctor. I can see it on the caller ID. And I'm thinking, if he's calling me this early in the morning, this can't be good.
Okay.
So I say, hello. And he says, hey, Rob, it's Kevin. I know we have an appointment tomorrow morning, but this news is so good, I didn't want to make you wait. And I said, okay.
He said that. That was his quote.
I said, tell me. Well, remember there were two sort of blood panel scores that they used to do a cursory examination of the liver?
Yes.
And we talked about them before. One is the Child Pew score, and one is the MELD score. The Child Pew score is a letter grade score. You want it to be as good as possible. When I was in the hospital, I was rocking a C. As of this week, I'm at an A. But that's not what's remarkable.
Okay.
The MELD score, 16, is when you start shopping for a liver transplant. As my doctor said,
when you get on
LinkedIn.
Slow down a second because I want to make sure we get this part.
Okay.
16. Is this a number you want higher or lower?
You want it to be lower. He said once you hit 16.
Where were you when you were in the hospital? Do you know?
15.
You were that bad?
Yeah, and he said 16 is not a definite transmit, but that's when you want to get on LinkedIn and start shopping around. So I was at 15. The last time I was in his office, I'd gone down to a 14. He said, that's really good news. We need to keep up what we're doing. If we can get you down to a 10 over the next few months, it's going to make me feel a lot better about where you're at. Well, as of this week, I'm at an 8.
Love it.
And
that's awesome. That's awesome, man. It's freaking awesome. All right.
I'll see you
back at work tomorrow.
Yeah, see you tomorrow.
My main liver enzyme, which is called the GGC, has cut almost in half, well on its way to normal.
So this is a result of the lifestyle changes immediately taking effect, correct?
Or a bad misdiagnosis at the hospital.
God, either one, it doesn't matter to me.
That's really good news. It's really good news, and they're still working on some blood issues that are relatively mysterious. My hemoglobin is still relatively low, and they're trying to figure out why that is. Because
now start phasing out the lazy tongue then?
Not until my hemoglobin hits 10.
No, I mean, can you stop phasing out the? I mean, fake it, because it's driving me out of my mind. Yes, there you go.
You got it.
I know it. Look, Oscar's not going to say he agrees with me, but that is phenomenal.
This has really taken a lot of the
freak factor out of meeting with a specialist who's probably going to give you a lot more info on how to deal with this.
But this is, again, this comes with the ultimate don't be happy. Don't get right. happy. But he said this from the cursory overlook of where your scores are and where they were is looking more and more like it's going to be something slightly chronic and treatable as opposed to a long range issue down the road.
Do you see, because obviously when we talk about liver, the alcohol, which you're well over a month without.
Yeah.
And to be honest with you, I can enlighten you as to the older you get, I speak for myself. Mm-hmm. I don't want to speak for everybody else. I can safely tell you that the older you get, the easier that gets, at least for me. Because it's just not worth it.
This is the thing that's crazy. And I was thinking about this yesterday. I don't miss it.
I don't miss it.
Now, look, I would love to be eating the food that I used to eat. That I miss. I'll have to get used to that.
Right.
But as far as the ritual of making a cocktail every night, I have a glass of ice water. I've got something to sip on. I've got a glass.
But you make like 30 every night?
Yes. I made 30 death wishes against the people I work with.
It's really great.
But it is something.
Let me finish my question.
Please.
What I was going to ask you, so outside of that, which we know you know, that's fear of God. You immediately switch. Has anyone discussed, are there any other factors that you have to be mindful of? Whether it be diet, whether it be medication, do they pay attention to that now?
100%.
What's something we might not know about? Can we have your liver then?
Well, as far as the liver goes, there's been nothing sort of beyond stay away from anything that taxes your liver. And he gave me some medicines to avoid. For example, I can't take Ambien anymore. Excedrin used to be my go-to for headaches.
You sleeping better without the booze?
Yeah, I am. It took a little while. And I'm still getting up because of the hydration and the diuretic. I still have to take a break in the middle of the night. But,
that doesn't change either, whether you're on a diuretic or not. You know.
But as far as that, they're still a little concerned about my iron counts not keeping in balance with the rest of my blood. So he says, for now, let's not have any spinach. And stay away from extraordinarily high iron foods.
Stay away from high iron foods.
They're trying to kind of track whether or not I have that metachromatosis.
That condition your mom had.
And so that test is still...
Which is too much iron, which you never... I mean, I always hear...
That's the paint chips, though, right?
Yes, absolutely.
But so how great is that?
Almost sweet.
How great is this feeling this morning?
It's amazing to start the day like this.
So did you follow up with... How did he characterize it after he gave you the numbers?
This is yet another indication that I think we got extraordinarily lucky of catching it when we did. Because obviously these scores are reversible, and you're showing some function. He's eager to see where we're at as far as the actual liver action. But this is great.
You had a sonogram already, right?
Ultrasound.
Your liver.
Ultrasound.
Ultrasound.
Yeah.
Ultrasound.
And the other thing,
the liver's having a baby. No. I'm sorry. I get it. Right.
And then the other thing, when you talk about diet, I have to be mindful of carbs and things like that because of the diabetes. But my blood sugar has been really good all week. So
that's great. That's wonderful.
All is well right now. I mean, as much
good.
As can be.
All right. That's good. Oscar, you've been strangely quiet during this segment. I know you're probably waiting to weigh in on this.
Yeah. Well, for me, I'm happy with any good news. I want to be positive with Rob, but it's tough to do that when all we want is his tongue to do some sit-ups and some push-ups.
That's look at how he modified it right away.
Yeah, he got
it, right?
He
takes instructions.
Yeah,
he got it right away.
So
he takes instructions.
And Oscar also takes your lead because he didn't really have anything to jump on me about, but as soon as you said lazy tongue, he's like, let's go.
Now, we've talked about it off air. We have. Yes.
Yeah. So, but you still didn't bring it up on your own.
I was trying to be nice.
Yeah, okay.
Trying to be nice.
The
other side is I feel like Rob is at a point here where he could probably do the show every day. Like, he sounds great.
Well, except for the doctor's appointments, yes, that's the plan.
Okay, I'm sitting here. This is the best we've heard you in some time.
And
this,
you know, amazingly, Oscar's not
isn't
so good.
I wonder how the right after you get your great news, you get two guys that can ruin it for you. Isn't that special?
Guess what? Really? You're not even close to ruining it. Keep trying.
Vacation.
No, we've been living this too. You know, you might not be aware of that, Rob, but we've been. Suffering through this as well, and been concerned about it. It with every bit of good news that we get and positive news that we get, two things happen. Joy that my friend is going to get to the other side of this, hopefully, and continue to get better. And B, frustration and deep-seated resentment and anger that that you haven't been at work in over a month.
This is true.
So it's a balance. It's a balance thing, you know. It's
life
it's
is about yin and yang, Mike.
Yeah,
you know, the good and the bad, the sweet and the salty.
Well, really. And now with that said, but anyway, good news is good news. We're busting your balls for fun. I have to say, yesterday, I don't know what was posted online regarding the show, but let me give you the sound about this is the sound emanating out of Podville Media yesterday, ladies and gentlemen. You know, gotta tip the cap when the tipping of the cap is due. And Mr. Santana last week had said to me, he had said, go get a booster. This thing's not over. You never know when it's going to rear its ugly head. Be careful. Err on the side of caution. All those things you said. And lo and behold, yesterday, a major COVID scare at the Ville.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, look, the vice president announced yesterday she has COVID.
Yes.
Like this is not over at all.
Right.
And we got
fortunately the president hasn't been exposed because they don't speak. But
how hard is that job when you're press secretary? And just a quick
side. They haven't been together in 8 days. It was something like that. It's like, wow.
Wow.
Talk about being put on the shelf.
A quick side note. Matt.
It's like marriage.
Bloom, my mic, at least for me, is in phase, so it doesn't sound right. Talk to Rob Ford. He knows how to run the equipment. God bless you. You don't. And ask him how to fix that. Thank you.
You sound just fine on this end.
Yeah, but I'm the one talking.
I'm trying to figure
talk to
out
Rob
what's
Ford.
Going on.
Please,
with
for the love of God, listen to me. Thank you.
Maybe if you were a little more precise with your tongue, it would help.
Oh, well, I'm just fine. Vice President Harris announces yesterday she has COVID. Yesterday morning.
You don't think it's just a ploy to get attention, do you?
No, she's beyond that.
She knows she's not going to get any.
Yeah, yeah.
like the bad kid?
Right.
This morning, yesterday morning, I get a call around 8 a.m. that says, We have a pretty good protocol, I think, for any small business in America, where we have these rapid tests available at all times, and you can take them home, and it's at our expense. They're available, and one of our team members wasn't feeling so great, and
spared no expense,
and they pop positive on two rapid tests, which means we go into our COVID protocol, which means I have to let as many people know as possible right away.
Well, he told almost everybody.
So
hey, I have a question. Yes. So. Do you immediately know who it is when you find that out? Okay.
Yes.
All right. So you immediately
who won
know
the
who
office pool?
Well, I'm not going to share their name because
no, I'm kidding. It's a
that's,
joke.
You're not supposed to do that.
Right.
I get that. It was O'Brien. No, I'm just kidding.
It's no one you've met. No one I've met.
Well, no. Of course.
O'Brien.
Which that's 90%. That's 90% of the employees
by design. So no one
just keeping
met.
You safe.
Yes.
Mike. Social distancing.
So scary.
So then. Yes, so then we ahead. Get in. So essentially, I have to wave Matt off. So Mike is great because Mike's like, let's just you deal with the 18 people here. We'll take care of the show tomorrow, no problem. And as soon as I hang up with Mike, I get into the protocol to make sure everyone's safe. My wife shares an office with a person, so then nothing's back to normal. And I don't know if we'll ever be back to normal,
right?
But we are getting to a place where we're more comfortable. With this protocol where we just go into a testing phase and it's going to be like the flu in the long run, but you have to be ever vigilant. We want everybody to be safe.
Can I ask a question about the protocol?
Yes.
When you notified Pony that he should go back home, did you mention that he should mention it to me?
Oh, absolutely.
Because I was here at 8:45 going, Pony, Are we going to do the show?
Really?
I said, Matt, you call Rob. I got to call 18 other people.
Pony.
I got pony, like, that pony, is when pony. I got home. I was turning around. The moment I got home, I was checking to see and make sure everything was good.
What do you mean the moment
Rob,
you got home?
You've got
you
a car phone.
A fucking cell phone?
I do, but I was driving.
You were driving? Oh, my God. I try to stay out of the fray. I'm sounding like Jerry Seinfeld now. God. Coddled. Coddled. Coddled.
But I didn't know what was going on, so I sat here for 20 minutes.
Rob, I am so sorry.
And I was just, and I mean, I'm not going to be relieved that someone popped a positive, but I, you know, I don't know what's going on. If
yeah.
Mike has had a horrible injury or something like that, I just want to be informed.
I
get it.
The great,
you have every right.
The great
to
news
informed.
Is this: I no longer will ask a friend, a colleague like Matt Bloom to call you. I can call you. So that's
no,
that
just
won't ever
just a
again.
Simple text will do.
Well, it doesn't matter. I mean, I just I'll take care of it.
Well, I didn't know how you were handling it. All that I said was, "Well, he said Pony can be here." I said, "No, no, you know, we'll reconvene
yeah.
him, and we'll
yeah,
see
yeah.
if Rob can do it tomorrow." I didn't know anything after
I
that.
I then call Matt Bloom and let him know. And
by
say,
the way, the no-no was not to protect Pony. The no-no was the idea of doing a program with it. I forgot yeah. about Rob. To be perfectly honest, I did too. I forgot Rob.
I was actually shocked.
Here.
I was like, "Well, does he not just?"
I forgot
with
Rob was going to be here. Okay. I blew it. My fault.
No, no,
mea
no.
Mea culpa. I thought it was a total no. meltdown. So
I blame the CDC because if yeah, the okay. COVID was been cured by now, then
let
none
me tell
of this
you
happens.
What I freaked out about is that what Oscar said to me is that
he
Shannon,
an office. Yes,
Shannon was next to this person that
well,
they
shares an office
to,
with the person
that they worked together yeah. in the same office, yeah. and then I immediately thought, uh-oh, and then I thought Oscar, uh-oh,
Domino,
and that was
yeah,
it.
And
but,
then Santos.
But the, so far, only the one person, and that person's home for a few
home.
Weeks.
No, they'll be home for the
10 weeks.
The rest of the week.
All right.
For us, I remember when you couldn't get tests. So now we have
yeah,
more than
true.
Enough, and everyone here has tested negative.
Good.
And continues okay. to test negative, and I know there's an incubation period. But
so a little hot spot in D.C. right
yes.
now, right?
Yeah.
D.C.'s getting problematic
and
again.
Matt, when you walked in, what was on your little desk right there?
A test.
Yeah. So you come in, you get tested,
mm-hmm.
you get your clear, and then you're okay. Bottom
That's
line.
Good. Oh, yeah. Well, but I mean, it's just still there.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
it's still
top
safe.
Of mind.
So with that said, even though I don't have any contact with anybody up there, I bit the bullet immediately after getting the phone with you, mm-hmm. off the phone with you, and scheduled my test. The availability they had was in the evening down here. And it was scheduled. You have to schedule an appointment. It's not like the first booster, rather, I could just walk in. And by the way, that was the slacker booster, where I walked in and I had a card in my pocket. I said, "Do you need my card?" "Nah, it's all right."
It just, yeah, even on mine, they just kind of wrote it in the margin.
Yeah. So I get there. It's 6 p.m. and I walk into a virtually empty. There was one other customer in there, and I thought there was a chance that he was up to something hinky just because he looked weird. He looked like one of those weird guys that's going to do something crazy.
Was
but
this
I just,
like a doctor's office or a
no, this
patient
is a drugstore. This is
oh,
a
drugstore
where
okay.
I got my last booster. I go into the drug.
Okay.
And it is virtually empty. And what's nice is, and I'd like to give a shout out to the people of Walgreens. Who, you know, if you happen, thank you, I'll do that too. If you happen to walk into a totally empty pharmacy, drugstore, you can still feel as though you're there with five people in the queue.
Absolutely.
Because they will make you wait a half an hour
mm-hmm.
while they're up there dancing with their pills. And what's even better is when you're dealing at the counter with the same lady that is dealing with the drive-through window. And she forgets you're there.
Yeah.
One customer, me, and she
That's
forgot.
It.
And there was no, I mean, Zed Bagel brainwave activity with this woman. Zippy, 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 zippy. I don't begrudge anybody that's out there slaying the dragon in this economy, but she forgot me. And the communication from her consisted of this. Just absolute tapped out of it. So I go up to the counter because I'm an advocate. Excuse me. I'm going to sneeze. I'm so upset. I'm going to sneeze. Look into the light. Look into the light.
That's from the, booster right there.
The booster. So I go in and she says, oh, I'm sorry. I'm running the drive-thru too. I said, just to...
Yeah, no S. I'm standing here watching you do it.
Just to go over there and sit in the seating area and the pharmacist will call you. little did I think that there was the possibility that I would deal with a more lethargic individual than the girl. That's not true. But in the case of the pharmacist down here in Death Town, yes. I understand that these people are just constantly filling. It's 24/7.
Oh, sure.
It's nonstop. It's a line of people going, I've fallen and I can't get it. It's constant.
Was it one of those pharmacists that's a little older and his white jacket doesn't fit that good?
No, he was a fit man. Well, fits. He was not fat. He was not fat. What he was, what he appeared to be, was exhausted. And he immediately takes on the "you're not a human being" persona with me, and I'm like, "How you doing? Long day." And the response he gave me when I said that, because I like to, have some kind of communication. The response he says, "Long day," and he goes, "That was the response. That was the response that I got."
I'm like, "Very nice."
I guess it was a long day. I said, "How's the traffic been with the second booster?" He said, "For about a day and a half, it was crowded. Not anymore." Welcome to the messaging. Welcome to, as I talked about last week on the show, Oscar. Welcome to the lack of messaging. Nobody gives a rat's ass about the second booster.
You have to be your own advocate.
You have to be your own advocate, but they could do a better job, but they don't really have it in hand just yet. I'm taking my recommendations on everything I've read from Oscar's dad, from the members of his family. Yeah. That's what I'm doing. So, and then it's no fuss, no muss. I'm out of there. But there
total
are
time
so,
commitment?
45 minutes.
You should do what we
the
do
shot,
up here.
The shot was 40 seconds.
You should do what we do in Leesburg here is we actually get the shot at the drive-thru. Mm-hmm. They put the syringe under the little spring
it's
and they open
one.
The drawer. Yeah.
That's and an extra long
and
syringe.
You just sort of lean into it.
And then you're out of there. So here's the thing. When I got my first booster on my little card,
yes,
the slacker guy, and I mentioned this to the pharmacist yesterday, I said, he didn't fill out the area where I have a booster. It was kind of... I had to track down from you guys when I'd gotten it,
yeah,
but
right.
That's the space. He goes, oh, yeah, okay. And I went, slacker. And the guy looked up to me. This is exactly when I went, slacker. And I looked at him for a reaction. He looks up at me and goes, and
blank
looks back
faced.
Down.
Yeah.
And then I said, and of course, he gets done doing the shot. I said, well, you're all set. I said, and you have to fill that out. And then he fills it out.
Even
now,
better.
This is the part where I didn't turn around.
Yes.
I didn't go back in. I was done for the day. I didn't want to deal with it. He wrote down under where you see we all have our vaccine cards, where the date is supposed to be, DD, or no, MMDDYY, okay? Month, day, year.
Right.
That's what it is.
Correct.
And he wrote down, if I read it correctly, June 21st. 2022.
Well, Mike, you have something now, to look forward
any,
to.
I, is there somebody that's that completely out of it that they just would have written down? I looked at it for like 5 minutes in the car. I'm staring at this card where they filled in the other one, which was October of 2021, where I got my first booster, and I'm reading. On April 26th, 2022, I am reading in the slot where he's supposed to put the date that I'm getting my shot, June 21st, 2022. Go figure.
Yeah.
I have no idea. Is that because
it's not even six
I have
months.
To wait? Do I have to wait till 4 months after that if they're going to do it again? Is there something I'm missing? And I guarantee there may very well be.
There could be, but
somebody's going to say,
what about a little instruction?
No, that would require communication. And they're just overburdened. They're overburdened.
Is it just handwritten?
Yeah, it's handwritten.
Then that's correct it.
They've all been, well, I don't know if I'm supposed
what about
to or not.
Some whiteout.
Yeah, it's not like you're going to go to COVID jail.
The card,
fix
by the
your
way,
card.
With the second, well, I don't know if I'm supposed to or not. Come on.
Well, you've got to be
maybe
accurate.
Maybe that's the date. Maybe that's the
I think it
date.
Is. I think it that, is. Yeah. Where you're maybe eligible for the next one.
That I would be eligible for maybe. The next one on, well, who knows?
I mean, but you went in there with a blank card. Who cares?
I know. I have my original two.
I get it. But I'm saying if you're missing one, it's not like we're collecting all four and we're eligible for the grand prize.
Well,
no
I got
one really
it right
cares.
Here.
Yeah, like,
I got,
yeah.
I got, like by the way,
McDonald's
he
Monopoly.
With,
yeah.
He slashed me with a needle. It hurt.
That's like, ridiculous.
Mm.
And also, anyway. Did they set you free right away? Aren't you supposed to wait 15 minutes?
No, that was the original one. That was the original one where you sit around for 15 minutes.
Yeah, don't go into shock or something.
Well, I was driving, I was halfway home. I'm very close. It's literally 2 miles from my front door, and I'm driving around. Carla had to come out and get me out of the car, and I said to her, she opened the door, and the first thing I said was, pull one out. pull one out. So getting back to you, Oscar,
yes,
and Podville, and then I have a question for Rob about this same situation. Regarding the D.C. area, downtown, oh, and the person who may have popped for it,
yes.
That will go nameless, did this person have any indication where they might have contracted it?
Well, I mean, we all have different modes of transportation. Some people take the metro. Some people take public transportation. It could be anywhere.
Could have been anywhere.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, here's what I would
do.
If I was running the show, I don't want to tell you how to run your business up there. I don't have a hand in that. I'm a silent partner. But I will tell you, I would sit that person down, probably one of the younger people there, and go, have you been out clubbing?
No. This is actually
Mike.
This is the opposite, Mike. This is completely the opposite of
for
the
last
that would ever
13
do this.
Months. I've been wearing a mask when I go to my raves, and people look at me like I'm not cool. But
did you share one of those candy pacifiers with somebody?
Well,
those kids still doing.
This
that?
Is what's fascinating is I'm actually thinking
how remarkably precise.
The kids still doing that, Oscar? They
sure.
Still
no,
take the
no they're not.
Thing, no?
If they are, I don't know about it. But
well, it's a big thing in Podville Media, but not so much in the club.
New sponsor on the Mike O'Mara Show. Hi, I'm Mike O'Mara for Ecstasy Pops.
Charms.
Well, it would be candy flipping. It would be the acid and ecstasy in the pacifier.
Oh,
that's what
yes.
that is.
Sorry
yeah.
about that.
The,
I got it.
I'm actually impressed by if so the days of, and you remember this from radio, Mike. Somebody feeling like tired or saying they have allergies and never doing anything about it, just so then everybody just gets sick. The days of those are gone because every time now somebody even has like a head cold or allergies.
Was that a dig at your compatriot here? Was that a little bit of a dig that the allergy thing is?
This is just at anyone that would come to work.
You think he was digging you? I thought he was digging you.
No.
I don't think so.
The man
just
has a failing liver. That's completely
okay.
different.
I got it.
I just remember getting sick the first day of vacation. Every vacation. That's what happened.
Yeah. Oh, back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Worst colds I will ever remember would be when the adrenaline stopped flowing,
yep.
The flight instinct, the fear instinct stopped on the old Don and Mike show, and we'd be on vacation, and I would be like,
the flight instinct, Pony. Yeah. That's the name of the show.
Hey, congratulations! You're off for 2 weeks. It's Christmas time, and you're going up to New England.
For me,
pneumonia.
I thought the foresight for someone to actually feel like they're having a head cold from allergies and then taking a COVID test, I think that's going to become the new norm.
Yeah, I took a rapid test last week. I woke up with a sore throat. It was just sinus drain, it turned out. But I did take it in the morning because you flip out.
Yeah, you want to know at least where you stand.
And you have
bumping on the golf course.
Yeah. Again.
We have the ability to do it if you have those rapid tests. I mean, this would have been such a luxury a year ago. You
know? I went on, so I know we had roughly 40 in stock here, and then I went on Amazon. I'm like, oh, how long is this going to take? We ordered 180 tests that will be here by Friday. Boom.
Yeah, done. And do it, and you have to be proactive because, you know, all you need is one major city. You get one major city with a spike and you're screwed.
Yes. You know? But the bad thing about these Amazon tests, they're lightly used.
Pre-owned.
That's right. I just hope that I pick a negative one when I get my test.
Right. Or they could sell them like they sell Cadillacs, where taking orders soon.
Soon. And hey, Mike, General Motors, option you want.
Seriously, sniff my Irish bag, GM, all right, with your ads that say, taking orders soon. What a ridiculous commercial that is.
You can customize your car, Mike.
It's ridiculous.
Do you want a radio? We can do that. That's what they want you to do.
I think that Oscar being proactive, so if this thing... what is the speculation around the D.C. area? Do they... Are you hearing... is it any kind of story yet?
Was it 3 weeks ago, Philly went to an all-mask policy?
Right.
We're at Podville Media. We're at an all-mask policy again. Mm-hmm. Yep. I think that the writing was on the wall.
Were you a little freaked out yesterday?
I was. You know what? I was more... If I'm not mad at our team members. I'm over this. But you have to stay vigilant.
And when you say over it, you're like, go ahead, Rob. I'm sorry.
I was going to say, I'd have to imagine Oscar wouldn't have been scared as much as he would have been in management mode.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, and that
Well, a little frustrated, too, with the people that if you're riding Metro, wear a mask. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess I'm saying, Mike, I think even the person with the best, and I'm not saying the person that comes to work rides the Metro. I don't know that. I'm saying it's the big city.
Right.
Pony saves money, though, by riding on top of the trains, like India. They lose them occasionally.
The frustration stems from...
Ponies at Farragut West.
Where all the headlines are, at least that I see on the news, are like, yes, no more masks. And then you freak out. You're like, okay, no more masks. And then like 2 weeks later, we're back at the mask policy.
Well, I played on the Soundtown last week. I played a clip of the people on the jet when they made the announcement. I think it was Southwest where they didn't have to admit it. It was like, yay, duh. You know, because I mean, really, I don't know if I would be on an airplane.
Oh, I'd wear a mask. I think I said it that day. I was like, I'm still going
to
wear a mask.
In that kind of close proximity to other people. Let's see.
You get a definite demotion in my estimation of you if anywhere on social media, and I've seen it probably 5 or 6 times. Excited to travel on a plane without a mask. And it's like, why would you be excited to do that? I know it's an option.
I'm sorry to cut you off, Rob. You're absolutely right. So there is, and as of the last 3 weeks, I've noticed it even more. You'll walk into Wawa, and I'm as guilty as anyone else, and I'll see, like, our business partner, Charlie, will wear a mask. He'll put his mask on, and I'm like, oh, I forgot mine.
Right.
And he's like, oh, I'm just wearing mine just in case. I want to be vigilant. And I was like, oh, I should probably do that.
I'm seeing less and less around
here. And you walk into... any convenience store or even lunch that's back, and you see people, like half of them are wearing masks, half of them aren't.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It says here from The Guardian, this story broke, when did that come out? Show me the date, please. Oh, I guess you don't want to do that, Guardian. Thank you. But it says here that more than half of Americans show signs of a previous COVID-19 infection.
Mm.
More than half. Mm. That's pretty stunning. Right there.
Yeah. And I think it's higher in kids, I saw this morning.
Yeah, 3 out of 4 children.
Also,
according to a new report released on Tuesday.
There's a. There we go. And maybe this is more of a personal aspect. I'm hearing more and more stories about long COVID than I've ever heard before, which is really off putting and scary.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And well, and you motivated me to get a second booster because of that very reason where. Yes, infected potential always.
Mm-hmm.
I think we have to be aware of that new reality.
Yeah.
But if you are cleared to get a certain vaccination, I went with the data. I went with that maybe I won't get as sick.
Do you feel anything? I'm curious.
After yesterday?
Yeah.
No.
Huh? Mike, your mouth.
What?
No.
Don't joke.
Maybe you shouldn't have taken the subway to the Walgreens.
I wrote on top of it, though.
Pony, that's right. Hold
on. Music Pony, this signal. There you go. How you doing, pal?
Sorry, I was talking to Ford about something.
Yeah, of course you were. So we're up on a break. That's a good time to not pay attention.
The
only
best
one
time.
Thing you have to do. All right. I'm on you today, Bloom. But anyway, we'll take a break. We'll come back. Rob, staying with us to the news homepage. Coming up next.
Hey, bro. It's me, California Twig.
What are you doing here?
When I'm not paying $47 for a gallon of gas, I get all of my Twitch needs from the Mike O'Mara Shopping Center. Click the banner at MikeOMaraShow.com and have your essentials delivered to the East Coast or the Best Coast or anywhere in between.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, and congratulations to Twitch. We never mentioned the fact that he's doing great with his other gig, too.
He is
the announcer for Wheel of Fortune. If you ever want to see
Mark Riddell, I love seeing him every
he's
night.
He's right at the beginning of that. Hey, mortgage rates have now hit 5% for the first time in a decade. That will probably be the new floor, the bottom, moving forward. So what does it mean for you? Well, it means that if you're purchasing a new home or you're looking to consolidate debt, it's going to be more important than ever to work with a team that you can trust. Take my advice. Take Rob's advice. Take Oscar's advice. Call my friend Mark Livingstone and his team at Cornerstone First Financial today. Limited supply and high demand dictates you work with a company that can absolutely make sure you are the best prospect to a potential seller. It's competitive out there. Who'd have thunk it? That's what Mark and his team can do for you. No two scenarios are the same, and you need a company that will get down to the nitty-gritty of your specific situation, whether it's a purchase or a refi. Plus, with their no-obligation rate quote, AAA rating with the Better Business Bureau, and 100% satisfaction guarantee,
satisfied.
Why would you call anyone else? Answer me that. Why?
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 Call Cornerstone First Financial, the number one choice of TMOS and all of our listeners, 202-625-1221. That's 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com. And thank you to Cornerstone for everything you've done for the Mike O'Mara Show over the years. They deserve your business, and we love them over there.
From the four corners of the World Wide Web and into your digital device, it's what you need to know. This is the homepage.
This is the homepage. And if you're not drinking your partner's blood, is it really true love, ladies and gentlemen? Megan Fox and Machine Gun Kelly.
Ooh.
He looks like a wonderful boy.
Really nice boy.
Absolutely a nice boy. Well, they drink each other's blood for ritual purposes, it says.
Oh, here. Well, at least it's not for pleasure.
Yeah, and not out of a goblet or Game of Thrones or anything like that. In an interview with Glamour UK.
Glamour?
Megan. Glamour magazine. Megan says, it's just a few drops. But yes, we do consume each other's blood on occasion for ritual purposes only. I don't think it can end well when there's blood involved. Remember Billy Bob that had and Angelina
the
Jolie when
vial?
They had the,
yeah.
The
yeah,
vials?
Yeah, for sure.
Come on. Megan does tarot card reading and is into astrology and does metaphysical practices and meditations. Of course she does.
Reminds me of the old Stephen Wright joke. I played solitaire with a deck of tarot cards and three people died.
Thank you, Stephen. So when there's a new or a full moon, oh God, Hollywood, please. She has a special ritual she does, which is where the blood comes in. Here's the quote. When I do it, it's a passage or it's used for a reason and it is controlled where it's like, let's shed a few drops of blood and each drink it. He's much more haphazard and hectic and chaotic where he's willing to just cut his chest open with broken glass and be like, take my soul. Okay, good for those.
Well, that's nice.
Isn't that sweet? Thank you, Machine Gun.
Yeah.
Machine Gun. What's your name going to be? I'm going to name myself after a famous murderer. Yeah, right, congratulations.
But also, I mean, Machine Gun is like very 1940s. It's like not even like a modern gun. It's just, I don't know. Yeah. But at least she's not, you know, defecating in his bed.
Well, that'll be later today, Rob.
Okay.
Al Pacino turned 82 on Monday.
Looks great.
And he celebrated at an Italian restaurant in West Hollywood with his 28-year-old girlfriend, Noor Al-Fala.
Good man.
By the way, she, listen to this bio.
Yeah.
She is the ex of Mick Jagger. And by the way, I don't like to do super snarky. It's just right. The news happens to be snarkable today.
All right.
She is the ex-girlfriend of Mick Jagger. They dated in 2017. Now, Mick is 78 now, but clearly he was probably too young because then in 2019, she was seen with Clint Eastwood, who's now 91.
Yeah, 90, right? Oh, my God.
Which must have been too old. So she found Pacino, who's 82, right in the middle. Mm. Right in the middle. There
I was willing all to right. bet that she drinks Al Pacino's blood but doesn't even know it.
Yeah, it's dusty. Dusty blood, yeah. Are there any bands that you can't stand because you find them overrated? I think we all have those.
Yeah,
of course.
There is a website. It's called newarena.com. I love this list. I don't want to offend anybody, but I love this list because there are a lot of hits on the list that I agree with.
Okay.
Not hit songs, but they hit with my sensibilities.
Yeah.
Maybe you'll find some of your least favorites on it. I'm going to go from, how many do we have here? 10 to 1. You ready?
Yes.
Number 10, Metallica.
Oh. Well, I think they deserve the credit they get.
Yeah, says here, I agree.
To treat them, they did some writing with this, okay. Oscar. To treat Metallica like they're the best thing metal has to offer is just ridiculous. They're not bad or untalented, they're simply overhyped. Both radio stations and other media can be blamed for playing average songs too much. Next is number 9, Green Day.
Blasphemous. Yes. How dare they?
I knew you'd have trouble with it. Billy Joe Armstrong's voice, the punk equivalent of nails on a chalkboard, and the fake accent. It seems like everything they try to write is supposed to be some kind of statement. Here's number 8. People get pissed off. Bon Jovi.
Overrated.
Bon Jovi songs. I think I'd agree with that. I would too. Bon Jovi songs all sound the same. They said it. Too commercialized. Number 7, Oasis.
Yep.
They've had good tracks, but are just so full of themselves. Number 6, this is going to be tough for people, Genesis.
I don't see people really celebrating Genesis as much as I.
You might be right. You might be right about that. And now this is, for me, blasphemy.
Okay. U2.
They had some solid tunes, but they also had mediocre tracks. I don't agree with you two at all. I don't like
them. I don't know. They lost a lot of points with me when they forced their album onto my phone.
Oh, you hated that?
I hated that.
Okay. Paulie, I'm sorry. Number 4 is Kiss.
Totally agree with this. Jesus Christ.
Gene Simmons will do anything for an easy buck. It doesn't matter if it's selling coffee or delivering mediocre records on your front door. Being a sellout is the surefire way to be hated. However, Kiss embraced it fully. Number 3. Oh, my wife will hate this. The Doors.
Oh, not overrated at all.
The worst thing about Jim Morrison is his vocals put forth the image of a smarmy lounge singer. I can't help but imagine that he would be doing a lounge act in Vegas if he were alive today.
Disagreed. I love his voice.
And the last two, number 2 is Motley Crue. They had a few good songs. The rest were nothing but fillers. They fall under the bands that are okay category, so it'd be great if fans don't act like they're the most outstanding rock act to emerge from the 80s.
And also, they keep coming back. They have staying power, and that makes them even more annoying because there's very little to back it up.
Pam and Tommy! And the number 1 overrated band, are you ready?
Yes.
Hit the fanfare. Guns N' Roses.
I doubt it. No, Kiss would be number 1 in my eyes.
In terms of technical skill, Slash is not the best guitarist. They're not an awful band, but to say they changed the hard rock game is a stretch. And of course, when I was on the rock station up in D.C., The Edge, the ill-fated Edge,
yes,
lasted for like a little over a year, and I played the Cat Sounds when I was playing Guns N' Roses.
Who do you hate more?
Immediately, the first day. Guns N' Roses is my least favorite.
Really?
Absolutely.
Oh, my God.
I'm surprised. There's one band I'm surprised not on the list. I am so...
Meow. God.
One band that really I can't believe is not on that list. I am so sick of the Beatles.
Oh, my God. Talk about... not overrated, overhyped.
Yes, well marketed.
Would you certainly agree with that? All right, very good.
Yeah.
All right, let's switch to food now. Heinz, wonderful company, great catsup. They have a
Pittsburgh-based
Heinz. Yes, run by the famous Amato family.
Yeah, try the Amato tomato ketchup.
Yeah, it's like if you wanted to sell a tomato in Pittsburgh, you had to see the Amatos, and all of them sounded the same. I mean, you'd be sitting there at a produce stand on the side of the road, and some guy would get out of his car, walk up, and go, "If you sell those tomatoes without my permission, I'm going to make sure that you get in big trouble. I'm going to come back later on this afternoon and break both of your legs."
Meanwhile,
that's a Jim Amato shtick right there.
Papa Amato is at home in his darkened office stroking a cat.
What haven't I done for you?
On this, the day of your daughter's wedding.
I'm going to make you an offer you can't refuse. Mm.
Jim Amato is the godfather.
Look how they massacred my boy.
Jim Amato in the greatest role of his life, the remake of The Godfather in the role of Don Corleone. Yes.
I'll do this favor for you, but I want you to make him look as beautiful as you possibly can. All right?
For his mother.
Hey, Don Ciccio. My name is Vito Andolini, and this is for you. Ah!
Thank you. It's not where I expected to go with this. Heinz has a new product. I love doing the Jim Amato. It's called Dippin' Crunch. That lets you dip your burger into crushed up potato chips. They say it was inspired by a TikTok trend. Of course it was. So apparently some people are already doing it. They also recently tested it at a few Jack in the Box locations. Did somebody say Jack in the Box? On the West Coast. Obviously the chips wouldn't stick on their own. So it comes with crushed up chips plus a sauce, I guess ketchup paste, to dip your burger in first.
Amato
sauce. This is the best thing to happen to the potato chip since the deep fryer.
Let's see. The secret sauce and a spicy version. Those are the two versions they have.
I wish they'd keep it a secret.
Pittsburgh sauce. Charred on the outside, tender on the inside.
It can work with sandwiches, too.
Does it?
And putting chips in a sandwich is already somewhat common. But they're specifically selling it as a burger thing. You can find it at Walmart, Target, and some grocery stores. Yes, sir.
No,
I'm intrigued.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Worth trying.
A good burger doesn't need that.
Perhaps if it comes out and it goes wide, we can, have you try it. Couples in public. There are things you don't do. There are things, we are all couples. We're all paired off. We're all married men. Say, don't do this in public if you want to have a successful relationship. Number one, don't put each other down in public. You might want
to. Yeah, Carrie.
Rob, you might want to have a chat on that one. Number two, constantly bragging about your relationship. Just as bad, in my opinion. Just as bad. We're fantastic. We get along. We never fight. That type
That's
of stuff.
Right.
You don't do that. You don't do that in front of other people. Number three, big one for me. Too much PDA. Public displays of affection. Cannot stand it. Mm-hmm. Absolutely save it.
They're hiding something.
Yeah, get it. Get in the car, all over each other. I don't care, but don't do it in my living room.
Right.
Number four, public displays of anger. That's kind of related to putting each other down. But yeah, don't be a couple who gets into full-blown fights in front of
so
other people.
That's so embarrassing.
Right. That's
it's
the worst.
Really, it's not.
Also
not
trashy.
Cool. Number five, inappropriate flirting. Let me see what they say about this. Be careful about flirting with other people while you're out together, especially their friends. It can happen by accident without even realizing it. There are men that literally can't control that.
Yes.
If there's a hot woman at a table, the guy goes all, bat-ass, and he'll
Matt
start
Bloom
flirting
comes
with
somebody.
He's not in a relationship, Rob.
Yeah, but he loves to flirt. It's those eyes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Today, the day of your daughter's wedding...
Number six is marking your territory. That is sometimes it happens. That one sometimes happens right after inappropriate flirting, but not always. Oh, so if your, say, husband is flirting with the lady across the table, the wife will start interrupting conversations, or the husband will do this if it's vice versa. Ah. Being dismissive and being overly affectionate, that can be all forms of that. So don't do any of that, you know?
But if you really have to have
you just act like an adult. Don't be a child.
Act like a grown-up. Act responsible. Yeah. It's politeness.
Yeah.
It's basic etiquette.
If there's drama, you keep it in the car.
And keep your hands to yourself. Yeah. No heavy petting in my living room.
I try. I really do. I try to act like a grown-up. And to the person that was in the, I believe it was a Honda, might have been a pilot today, who cut me off in traffic and then refused to turn right while the light was green, I hope you didn't see that middle finger. Sorry about that.
Well, that shows a want of feeling.
Thank you. Now a little something-something. A man who found a 60-year-old McDonald's meal in his bathroom wall during a renovation was surprised by the smell of the ancient fast food. When asked about the smell of his discovery on Reddit, Rob, I don't have his last name, the guy's name was Rob, replied saying there was no smell and surprisingly no trace of mice. Kind of weird that's so knowledgeable. And surprisingly, no trace of mice. How about that? The old McDonald's branding on these bags show a mascot holding signs that say, I'm speedier, and custom-built hamburgers. That's the way it was in the 1950s and 60s. Newsweek reported that a Business Insider article from 2016 shared similar pictures of Mickey D's packaging that was dated back from 1955 to 1961. The only other place that McDonald's French fries this old have been located are in Rob Spiewak's colon.
Also speedier.
Yeah, speedier. There you go. We got to take a break. Rob, you're taking a powder. You're going off and do your tongue exercises.
Exactly.
And,
love you guys.
Great today. You sounded wonderful today.
See you on the bonus show, hopefully, with more good news. Got a doctor's appointment tomorrow.
Congratulations, and that is wonderful news. If you missed it, Rob Spiewak got great scores with his blood work. We love you. We'll see you soon.
If you missed the latest bonus show, you missed a lot.
Hello, Pluto.
Can I talk about my health now?
Yes.
Yes. You know what happens when I vomit blood? I come to work.
The llama would wake me up in the mornings by licking my forehead.
I said, F you. You should know how to make this drink.
This is the worst pandemic of my life.
The TMOS bonus show is your only chance to get that fifth hour of comedy power, and it's sent to your device every Friday. Try a week, a month, or a whole year. Your support keeps that comedy train chugging. Get your subscription today. Click the bonus show banner now at MikeOmeraShow.com.
I know that guy. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. April is Earth Month. That means a lot of us are giving a little extra thought about how we treat the planet. Wearing Rothy's shoes, as I did last weekend, can help. They make the most comfortable, stylish, and durable shoes and daily essentials. Wore them on Easter Sunday. They were my dress shoes. They're all from recycled plastic. Everything Rothy's makes is better for the planet. They've repurposed millions of water bottles into their signature thread that goes into all of their products. Plus, Rothy's are so wonderful to wear, and they're so popular. They're made with less wasted fabric, and they're designed to be durable and washable for a stylish fit that lasts. The clothes you wear every day shouldn't just look great. They should make you feel great. And by the way, when we got Rothy's as a sponsor on the Mike O'Mara Show, and I got their driving loafers, Carla went out of her mind because she's been wearing Rothy's for a very, very long time and loves them. Really, I think you ought to try Rothy's because you'll feel good about the planet. Rothy's help keep ocean-bound plastic out of the water, and if you buy their shoes, you know you did that too. I love you don't need to break them in, and they're incredibly versatile. Wear them with a suit, sweatpants, anything in between. Mm. We all love our Rothy's. When you're wearing Rothy's, your footprint feels lighter than ever. Get $20 off your first purchase today at Rothy's.com/TMOS. That's Rothy's.com/TMOS. Welcome back.
Happy
to
news
the Mike O'Mara
about
Show.
Rob.
That's really wonderful. That's really
all joking
terrific.
Aside, he, you know, we'll take anything. We'll take any good news.
And, you know, I think that there is a light at the end of the tunnel with this appointment that he's got on May 10th, I believe it is, where he's going to go to a specialist. And I am hoping getting a game plan for the future. And, I've been in touch with the specialist. And I've said, make sure that game plan involves coming back to work. Oscar's got more information for us, as a matter of fact, because it's yes, gamblers, get excited. There's degenerate gambler news right here on the Mike O'Mara Show. And a decision that was made regarding gambling from the O'Mara household, which we may or may not go along with. We'll take a break and we'll come back with more right here.
Do you like the Mike O'Mara bonus show? I've been a big fan of the regular show ever since it was on Terrestrial. But I think the bonus show is the group's undisputed masterpiece. It's an epic meditation on intangibility. At the same time, it deepens and enriches the meaning of the regular show. Listen to the brilliant ensemble playing of O'Mara, Spiewak, and Santana. The show is extremely uplifting. It's as positive and affirmative as anything I've heard in a podcast. The TMOS bonus show. Don't just stare at it, buy it.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. Everybody, food that's fast does not have to be fast food. I want to talk to you about Freshly. Quality meals without the hard work. Their meals are designed by nutritionists, cooked by chefs, then delivered fresh to your door. Other meal deliveries need to be prepped and cooked, but Freshly is ready to eat in 3 minutes. No one wants to spend an hour cooking dinner after a rough day at work or an infuriating commute. So skip the grocery store shopping and dirty dishes.
I'm so
and
sorry.
Go to it.
Who's playing this music?
Pony. That would be me. What's up?
This is the worst bed ever. It sounds like an alarm's going off.
Oh, yeah, it sounds like a truck's backing up.
It's background music that won't get us in trouble with
I'll never play this again. And then next time, make sure that I hear all of it before you decide to play, because this is garbage.
Okay.
Is that something you like?
I love garbage.
Thank you. Isolate that and send that one to me. Skip the grocery shopping and dirty dishes. Your Freshly meals arrive cooked and fresh every week.
Do you hear the truck backing up? It's like, hello?
Use the Freshly website or app to
Who thinks this is a good idea?
That fit your lifestyle with plans that work for your dietary needs. I feel like doing a motto again.
Preferences, taste, and family size. I love that they are delivered fresh, not frozen, and always delicious. We're talking about Freshly.
Yes.
Even though the message has been muddled today.
I love it.
The steak peppercorn is one of Oscar's favorite. You love that one. What is that your current go-to, the steak peppercorn
for
Freshly?
I had it for lunch yesterday.
It's yummy, yummy. Loving your tummy. Stop stressing about dinner right now. Freshly offering our listeners $125 off their first five orders when you go to freshly.com/TMOS. That's $125 off freshly.com/TMOS. Pretty good day for you so far, Pony, right?
Yeah. Pony, can you pull up the music? I want to hear a little bit more of
let's hear it standalone.
Some background music. Standard background music. Drums.
When did we ever play EDM behind our spots?
We stopped playing music with lyrics a while ago, and
is this genre, what you picked there.
Okay.
When you say, hey, someone's going to read a commercial over this track, put that up again.
Yeah, you know what? Can I give you a suggestion?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Can I give you a suggestion that's a little bit better?
Please.
You ready? Play this one. All right, turn that down.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now play this one tomorrow, okay? This is the one I want you to play.
Okay.
Let me just make it up out of here. There. You know what?
Yes.
iPads are not broadcasting tools.
I've been away from you a long time.
Thank you.
Worth it.
Only when I ever want to use, and I never use these pieces of shit. I never do, because they are so unreliable. And when I do, I sit there and I lay my finger right on the square that plays the song, and it's like, nothing. But if a pubic hair floats in from a bathroom and accidentally lands on one of those squares, it will trigger the sound. That's ridiculous.
Matt, where we land here, and this is a little show business. Please let me hear the beds you're picking.
Sure.
Thank you. Because that one was very... You would admit that's not probably the best
play. I have to reset the show right now, and I'm going to do it now with Jim Amato as the Godfather.
Thank you.
Okay, here we go. All right.
I don't understand what's happening with all of this music that Pony's playing from garbage right now.
Thank you. All right. Lottery Online.
Yes.
Before we get to this, I just want you to know, Oscar, serious, relaxed, not in the heat of battle discussion with Mrs. O'Mara. We are done going to the bad place down here. It is a depression seat. It is a hellhole.
Loserville.
It is not fun. It is Loserville, and never again. Never. I mean, this time, we've made that statement many a times when you're leaving a casino.
But this time, you mean
never again. But this was 3 days afterwards.
Yeah.
This was sitting down and having a conversation, and the answer was no. That doesn't prevent me, as a degenerate gambler, from being intrigued when you say you can now play the lottery online. You can actually go right online and do it.
Mike, this actually stems from a story that I've been seeing a lot of, and it's because it's Maryland. Somebody in Maryland won $10 million and they never actually...
They never claimed it?
They never claimed it. And then another story came out in my feed where someone won $1 million and never claimed it. And I sat there and I said, well, there should be an online way for you just to play the lottery. If I can bet on the Yankees or the Red Sox on FanDuel or whichever wonderful advertiser we have, then I should be able to do this.
Yeah, online. You register and it's there. And if you win, it's
MyBookie.com.
MyBookie.com.
Yes.
Hopefully coming back in the fall for us. Yes.
So if I can bet on my teams through MyBookie, then I should be able to play the lottery through the national lottery system, if there's something like that. So then
you talk about Mega Millions, Powerball.
Start going online. Because look, as an immigrant, and my dad being in public health, while he made a great living, one of his traditions was to walk next door near the State Department to one of the liquor stores, and he wouldn't drink, but he would buy lottery tickets. Mm-hmm. And on Saturdays, before we would go to McDonald's, because what little kid didn't like that, we would sit there and I would go through the numbers and he'd open up the paper pre-internet and we'd check off the numbers. And he had this wonderful tradition where he'd maybe buy four or five tickets. And then he would look at them and then with a little pencil, he'd circle what he got right and what he didn't. Okay. And then at the end, and he goes, okay, we're not moving today. And he just ripped the
and
when they're all
that's
losers.
That's what right? I do when I, I notice I'll be at Happy Valley with all the captains of industry down there. And, a place where I have to point out financially, I feel woefully inadequate. I'm barely hanging on when I'm in there, but I love it. And it's a great experience to be around when you hear discussions that you just don't really participate in. Correct. And I, of course, am so insecure that I will say, hey, that house just went for sale. That means I'm going to play the lottery today again. Sometimes you get a laugh, sometimes you don't. But that's the way I always perceive it. I'm on the Mega Millions site here. It doesn't show me any place where I can play.
But there's also, I'll tell you in 2 seconds, and just briefly, there's also a line of thought that says, well, why would you ever play the lottery? Bet on yourself. Myself doesn't have a jackpot of $454 million in the Powerball jackpot, which is tonight, by the way. Myself doesn't have $43 million Mega Millions jackpot, which draws on Friday.
What's the one that's tonight?
Powerball. $454 million. And I've stumbled upon we have zero advertising on this. This is a free plug.
$454 million.
Yes. Play.jackpot.com. And these guys have cracked the code to allow you to bet from home, buy a lottery ticket from home, and then they'll notify you if you win. So if you're in Maryland and they would have used this website, you don't even check your numbers. They literally
play
tell
lottery
you.
Online and win big with jackpot.com.
Play.jackpot.com. Yes.
This says jackpot.com. I'm not sure.
Is it this
coming
website?
Soon, the new way to play the lottery. Sign up now to hear first when we launch in your state.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's letting me.
Maryland
my state.
Like, is good to go. DC is good to go.
I'm not going to sign
but,
up.
But think about this, Mike.
Right.
If it's $2 a week,
mm-hmm.
it's better. And I'm not, if you're a small business owner, you own a bodega, I'm sorry. I'd rather just knock it out here because I'm evidently, I'm going to forget. I'm forget I had the if you, ticket or anything like that.
This is always a fun exercise, yes. And you can play at home as well. If you were to, the first thing, that $400, you cash that, you deposit that check,
yes.
You get with your financial advisor,
correct.
That you have recently hired,
correct.
To manage your Mega Millions, and you put it in the proper account with a level of liquidity that allows you to fish,
yes.
Something out for you, what do you spend it on?
Right
what
away?
What would be the first thing you would do?
I'd fight for our democracy. I'd put $100 million straight to the Lincoln Project. God bless them. And I did my part.
Wow.
Yes.
What a kiss-ass move,
yes.
That is.
No, I'm serious.
Fantastic.
You can't take,
wow.
It with you.
Wow.
You can't take it with you.
Hey, Reed Galen, did you hear what Oscar said?
I
you
think,
ought to stay with us forever.
I don't know,
fantastic.
If Reed listens to the show still, but God bless you.
Why now? Why would that not happen? I thought he liked the
no,
show.
No, he loves the show. I just don't know if
okay.
He's still he's going to hear that. That's
right.
Not why I said
that.
You asked
okay.
Me on the spot where
all
that
right.
Money would
yeah,
go,
thanks.
Right?
Thanks a lot. Yeah, nice to see your loyalty involves the last 2 years and not a lifetime of support. You know, we could we could use a little help on this show. You know,
I think you're doing fine. You have a beautiful family. You play golf every day?
So does Reed. Reed's doing fine, too. You know, you're going to win the lottery. The first thing you do is give it to the Lincoln Project.
I want to fight for this democracy, Mike.
Okay. What would you do for yourself?
What would I do for myself?
Yes.
I divorce my wife.
Oh, no. Stop.
Well, I think you said, what? I thought we were just saying dream scenario.
That is terrible. That's horrible.
Well, no, I would
what
take care of her. She could do whatever she wants. And then I would...
Just live in separate houses?
No, I would move to Los Angeles.
Oh, you would move to L.A.?
Oh, in a heartbeat. I'd still
really?
I still do the show.
Okay.
So,
that's
I mean,
good
that's a
hear.
Priority.
All right.
But I'd move to Los Angeles. I'd set up a bachelor pad of all bachelor pads.
Yes.
And then I would live like Dan Blazarian from Instagram. If you know, he's living the...
Jeez, you are, ladies and gentlemen, his soul is full of gadgets. That is a sick human being we are dealing with right now. Wow. Oh my God.
And I course, keep the dog though.
If I win, not as much, yeah. As Oscar, $50 yeah. Million dollars to the Republican National Committee right away. Amen. We'll take a break
there
and come
balance.
Back with Sound Town if I don't get lost right here.
The Lord loves you. That's why you cry. Buseyisms. A dog eating grass means the holidays are here. Buseyisms. A broken rake is a kitchen necessity. If you know the secret, Buseyisms. Hello, dear people. This is Gary Busey. I played Buddy Holly, but now I offer wisdom. Do you have thoughts you want to share? Then you should be a TMOS talking head. Just email Rob at MikeOMaraShow.com and you can find yourself on a Zoom call with the three wise men of TMOS. Include a number and get ready for fun. TMOS Talking Heads, more fun than a Cincinnati margarine rally with extra red hots. Busey.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, turned it down. Pony hitting on all eight today, pal. Really. Do you know that one of the most important parts of my show prep every day, it's making sure that I have my liquid IV like I do right here, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yes.
Making hydration a priority helps us feel better on a day-to-day basis. We've got summer weather down here. It's going to be 90 degrees plus probably for the rest of the year. Well, up until October, November. Just one stick of liquid IV, hydration multiplier, and 16 ounces of water. Hydrates faster and more efficiently than water alone. Plus, liquid IV has incredible hydration flavors. I don't know how they do it, but their flavors are phenomenal. Better than anything you get
so
at a
many,
convenience store.
So many options.
Watermelon, lemon lime, grape, pina colada, and my beloved strawberry is so yummy. Plus, it has three times the electrolytes of traditional sports drinks. It's non-GMO. It's free from gluten. It's free from dairy. It's free from soy. Liquid IV has cellular transport technology. That's the optimal ratio of glucose, sodium, and potassium to deliver water and nutrients to the bloodstream super fast. Plus, Liquid IV is out to change the world. They've donated over 20 million servings globally. Grab Liquid IV in bulk nationwide at Costco, or you can get 25% off, and I recommend it highly, when you go to liquidiv.com and use code TMOS at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order when you use promo code TMOS at liquidiv.com. Experience better hydration today at liquidiv.com. And the promo code for that, I think you know it. I think you love it. It's TMOS.
Sound. Did you hear that?
Make some noise.
Sound Town.
Here's a weird one. I'm involved in Little League so much, and I go to a lot of Little League games, but we fortunately, thank God, have not had this. This is the sound of a Little League game going on, and in the background, somebody starts a gun battle. And you hear the reaction from the parents with the gunfire during the middle. God, it never escapes. You never escape from it in the middle of a Little League game. Listen to this. Guns, ladies and gentlemen, guns. Terrifying,
man.
To hear that. And I mean, that just sounded like somebody opening up. But horrible. Really.
I would pause and like, is that firecracker? Like, you just don't know.
You don't know at first. And right? Then you hear the realization as they realize. And then you think, you know, first thing I would think is stray bullets flying around there. Get on the ground, kids. Now, we switch to some good news. Now, cancer survivor flying back, I think from the Carolinas, the pilot lets the cancer survivor make the announcements on the plane. I love this. Listen to this wonderful, sweet human moment. Or you could play the guns again because you're a complete and total idiot. Listen to the kid on the plane. God damn it. It's your fault, Pony.
I thought you were doing it on purpose.
No, I was not. No. The cancer survivor was given a Uzi machine gun and was able to.
And now I have to go back to Jim Amato again.
No, this is the cancer survivor coming back from the Carolinas. Pilot lets the kid use the PA on the plane.
Welcome aboard. We're going to North Carolina.
Welcome That's aboard. Sweet. We're going to North Carolina. I just love That's that. Sweet. That was super sweet. There's a 100-year-old birthday being celebrated by a former Tuskegee Airman. Mm. And this individual wants to get a lot of cards and letters. Listen to this, and then you might want to send him a card.
In Tuskegee, Alabama, it wasn't very acceptable to white people for black soldiers to be walking around.
Cut this out. I imagine there's going to be a flood of birthday cards coming in.
Oh, I'll read every one of them.
That's it. Aww. He'll read every single one of 100. Phenomenal.
Sweet.
All right. The trial. I try to avoid it. I read because it's almost becoming
Johnny
a crutch.
Depp's.
Johnny Depp's trial.
Oh, no.
But
it's captured. Yeah. Oh. It's its own phenomena.
It's its own phenomenon, Oscar, and I believe that the tide somewhere maybe in the last week has kind of flipped a little bit where it was Johnny being the a-hole. First of all, I believe in my heart of hearts, they're both a-holes, right? They're both just completely broken celebrities. But yesterday on the witness stand, this is, I believe, Amber Heard? A doctor testifying about Amber Heard and some of her personality disorders. This is, I mean, if you have to sit there at that desk and listen to this, it would curl your hair. I'm pretty sure this is a physician, but I don't know. It might be a psychologist. Might be the person that works at the counter at the drugstore. Listen to this.
We spent 12 hours directly with one another. One of the primary things I learned was that she had a very sophisticated way of minimizing any personal problems, externalization of blame, tending to have a lot of inner hostility that is attempted to be controlled. There can be actually a lot of cruelty, usually with people who are less powerful. They can react violently. They can react aggressively. They will often physically prevent their partner from trying to leave. Sometimes they act in a kind of a girlish way to be cute and to engender attention, but they can be actually very, very destructive. But mostly we call this administrative violence. So essentially this is saying that they'll make threats using the legal system. So they might say that they are going to file a restraining order or claim abuse. That person goes from being idealized, the perfect person, to dumpster.
Oh, I there love you have that. It. The dumpster fire.
Yeah, right in your backyard over there in Fairfax, Virginia.
We've all dated women like that. Right, and for men, for some people out there.
I wouldn't know anything about it. Moving right along, let's play a little game here, Oscar. The most expensive song for using in your movie, your TV show, or your TV commercial. There's one, the rights. There's one that's at the top of the heap. I'll give you one guess, and then I'll get right to it.
Is it, I have to ask genre. Just give me the genre.
Rock. And by the way, I'll give you a further hint. Way back in the day, it was used as the Washington Capitals.
The who?
The Washington Capitals. Their music when they would take the ice.
Yeah, is it the Who?
It's not the Who.
Okay. I don't know then. I don't know.
All right, here we go. See if you recognize this little ditty. One of my favorites, by the way. AC/DC, Thunderstruck.
This? It's wonderful, but this is played in every effing arena in the country.
Well, they're dirty little whores, and they get it. Man. I love it. I loved it before it was really super popular, but that's it. Thunderstruck.
Beautiful. Great song. Of all the songs, I thought it was going to be something you don't traditionally hear. That's why you have to pay for the rights.
Yeah, and I don't have the breakdown of the numbers, but it's plenty expensive if you want to do it. David Spade, one of my favorites, one of my all-time favorites, the definitive comedy bit on Huggers. I love this because this is so David Spade. It sounds like he would feel this way from the bottom of his heart.
This older woman was very sweet, and she saw me, and we both froze, and she goes, "Oh, no. Wait a second. Are you someone?" And I go, "Yes, I am." And she goes, "Give me a hug." I go, "Oh, no." Not because I don't like it. It's just, who's hugging still? I go, "Oh, maybe I could just get away with a fist bump." She goes, "Nope, come here. I'm a hugger." She did this 8-foot wingspan, and she came in for the kill, and I gave up. I said, "All right, bring it in. Let's both die. I mean, come on." Because I don't know what's going on, and she's sick. I don't. But that's how paranoid I am. And by the way, the old "I'm a hugger," can we get rid of that? I mean, it's not working anymore. "I'm a hugger," and that's it? No questions asked? That shouldn't work anymore for obvious reasons, and it definitely doesn't work with guys for probably 100 reasons. Come on, come here. I'm an ass grabber. Get in here. Oh, give me that juicy ass. No, it's okay. I'm just an ass grabber. Don't be weird about it. No. I grab asses and I like it. I'm an old school guy. It's part of my charm. I'm a camel toe grazer, and that's what I do. Just a little bit on the knuckles. I don't even feel it. I have no nerve endings. You can't get mad.
Did you hear that?
Make some noise.
Sound Town.
That's Sound Town for today. I want to thank everybody for joining us, and we'll be back tomorrow. Rob might be here tomorrow. I'm not sure. I forgot. I don't know what his schedule is. Who knows?
There's a lot of doctor's appointments that I don't know of the real doctor's appointments.
Yeah. Carla's got a solution. I'll tell you that off the air. We're horrible. We're soulless monsters.
It's been a month and a week. It's been 5 weeks. Come on. Yeah.
Carla says, start bringing in the subs. He'll be back. He'll be back in a day or two. That's it. We gotta get out of here.
You mean if Rob Mayer shows up, he's like, I'm better.
Oh.
I'm better.
Oh. The car will be driving into the parking lot before the show's over. We got to get out of here. We'll be back with a brand new episode tomorrow. For Rob Spiewak and Oscar Santana and Matt Bloom.
Hi, Matt.
Do better tomorrow, Pony.
I certainly will.
Thank you. This is Mike O'Mara saying so long, everybody.
Ciao, ciao.
Want more? Make sure you check out the Mike O'Mara Bonus Show. Get it at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Sayonara, sucker!
Wow.
Vision home!